Next on Prep Sports Plus, you'll meet one of the most versatile basketball players in the state. We'll go one-on-one with this female superstar. This diamond truly has become a field of dreams for the Patriots. He is on target to become a Junior Olympic hopeful. And our Academic Athlete of the Week continues to post big numbers. Prep Sports Plus is next.
Welcome to Georgia's only statewide high school sports and academics program, Prep Sports Plus, and by viewers like you. From the studios of GPTV in Atlanta, here's your host, Jim Giannacchio.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to another edition of Prep Sports Plus. I'm Jim Giannacchio. We are 1 week away from March Madness in Macon. The teams still involved in the postseason party are shooting for 5 state championships, of course, 1 in each classification. Over the last few weeks, we have featured some of those teams that have played well throughout the regular season and the playoffs. Now we'd like to spotlight some of the players that have made a difference for their basketball team. We begin with the story of a young man who has become the center of attention while playing many different positions. Cindy Beaumont has the story from Marietta.
Evan Brock's senior year at Lassiter High School has already been a slam dunk. Recruited early by the University of Alabama, Brock was also named a top 25 player by Atlanta's tip-off club. And averaging 18 points and 11 rebounds has earned him the title of leading rebounder in Cobb County.
Evan's role is like everybody else's role. It's to play hard, rebound, and play defense. But then in addition to that, he needs to show leadership out there on the floor. Needs to be an offensive force for us and get rebounds and take the big shots in close games.
He'll play all 5 positions, and we look to him as a scorer. He's our leading scorer. We always look to him to make the big shots, like Coach said.
He's a very valuable asset to our team, and I feel like, you know, other than scoring, he provides leadership on the floor for us.
You know, just lead by example, you know, keep people in track on doing, you know, the right thing and, you know, representing Lassiter well.
It's not too hard picking Evan Brock out of this crowd. At 6'9½", he towers over this relatively young team, and you can spot him all over the court. He covers no less than 5 different positions.
His biggest asset is his versatility. He can play the point. We play him quite a bit at the point. A lot of times we play him on the wing, which will be his natural position probably in college. But if there's a matchup situation, we'll always put him down low, and you know, that's where his natural position is.
I like playing the wing, actually. Even though I'm like 6'9", everybody thinks I'm center. But I like to play all the positions, but I mostly start out at the wing. You know, because I can handle the ball a little bit better, as in, you know, 6'9" people.
Well, you know, Evan's all around the floor, you know, getting rebounds, making passes, doing everything it takes to be just a great player. And I see him a lot. You know, he's always open, and I can always depend on him to get a basket when we need one.
The Trojans are hovering respectfully in the middle of their 5A division this year, having already met the likes of leaders Marietta, Wheeler, and Chattahoochee. But along the way, Brock was able to put up his 1,100th point, lofting him into second place on the all-time scoring list at Lassiter. How has this all affected our Mr. Brock?
He's so encouraging to us, and he never lets it get to his head.
Evan is a very well-mannered, polite kid. He's very down-to-earth. You know, this has not swelled his head or anything like that. He's been the same this year as he was last year. You know, he comes to practice every day. He's a delight to coach. He works hard in practice. And above all, he's been raised well.
So as this Trojan gets ready to ride that Crimson Tide, there's just a few more things to focus on in his senior year.
We're always trying to develop Evan strength-wise, you know, at all times. We're always trying to work on and develop his shot. He's already a good shooter. We're trying to put some more range on it.
I'd say the only thing that Evan really needs right now is just to put a couple more pounds on him, and I think he'll be unstoppable in the college level if he does that.
I like to excel in my game and also, you know, do the things that I need to do, as in when I go off to college and, you know, work on shooting and weightlifting, all that type of stuff. I just want to stay focused and keep everything at a level head and just continue to do what God has blessed me with the talent to do.
For Prep Sports Plus, I'm Cindy Beaumont.
Remember that name, Evan Brock. He's a good one. All right, thanks, Cindy. We continue with more one-on-one coverage and the story of a young lady that has GAC still in the hunt for back-to-back titles in AA. Brian Salmon has the details from Norcross.
GAC, the Lady Spartans, your 2000-2001 AA Girls State Basketball Champions, and the celebration begins.
This was the scene last year when Greater Atlanta Christian won the 2A State Championship, manhandling Union County 63-41. And bringing home the title, GAC rolled the back of then-junior Sherelle Baker, who scored 25 points. Baker didn't cool off after last season ended. She's still on fire, this season to the tune of 22 points, 7.5 rebounds, 7 assists, and 6.5 steals per game. Whew, it tires me to even say her stats.
Well, a player like Sherelle creates a whole lot of problems for your opponents in a lot of different ways because she's very quick and she can go by people. She shoots the ball well from the outside. She sees the floor so well that if they double team her and leave somebody open somewhere, she'll find them.
She's a really good defensive player, but like on offense, she can just turn it on. She can just single-handedly control the game.
Offensively, she opens up a lot for us. Like just her being able to penetrate, she can get past anybody, so that opens up a lot, and she can make incredible passes. That helps. And also, her defense, though, is really incredible.
Sherelle is undoubtedly one of the best players in the state of Georgia, maybe the country. She's definitely a big reason why the Lady Spartans are ranked number one in 2A. Miss Baker is a wiry 5'8 shooting guard with the first step of Cheryl Swoops, the pull-up jumper of Shamiqua Holdsclaw, and the passing ability of Tisha Pinichero. Sherelle will be taking those talents to the Georgia Bulldogs and the SEC.
I chose Georgia because, like, it's close to home and I have my family and friends here to see me play, and I've always wanted to go to Georgia. I like the basketball program.
I think she'll be great. I mean, she's already dominating here, so I think she'll do the same up there and, you know, just kick butt and take names.
Besides winning the second straight state title, Sherelle has set goals to possibly be crowned as Player of the Year in Gwinnett County and an All-American. But a bigger goal of hers would be to play against her mentor and workout partner, former Georgia Bulldog, Saudi Roundtree.
We're going to play. She told me if we win state, we're going to play one-on-one.
So if she sees this piece, what would you like her to hear you say?
That get ready to play one-on-one because I'm going to beat her. I hope she's listening.
Although they call her the Invisible Woman, Georgia fans will get an eyeful of her next year in Athens. And for you people at Greater Atlanta Christian, don't worry. Her number 22 jersey, which was retired earlier this season, will reside in one of these trophy cases for years to come.
They had, like, Sherelle Day here our senior night. Of course, we lost. We played awful, but it was still exciting getting my jersey retired. And the fans here cheering us on as a team. My team here to support me.
It was really sad. I started crying, but I was really excited for it. Like, only 4 people at our school have ever had that done. So, and this is the first time it's ever been, like, when she's not actually done with her career. So it was, like, a really special night.
She deserves to have her jersey retired, scoring over 2,000 points in her career, 500-plus of those coming this season. Good luck to her and the rest of the Lady Spartans on the road to the championship. Reporting for Prep Sports Plus, I'm Brian Salmon.
A future UGA Bulldog. All right, thanks, Brian. For the 5th consecutive year, GPTV will broadcast the Georgia High School Association State Basketball Championships live Friday, March 8th and Saturday, March 9th from the Macon Coliseum. On Friday, the action begins at 12 noon with the girls' single-A title game. The single-A boys will follow at 1:45 p.m. Then it's the AA Girls Championship at 3:30. Later, in prime time, it's the boys' AA finale, followed by the boys' AAA title game at 8:45 in the evening. Then on Saturday, the 2002 State Basketball Championships roll on with the girls' AAA Championship at noon, the girls' 4A finale at 1:45, and the 4A boys tipping off at 3:30. The primetime schedule begins with the girls' 5A finale at 7 p.m., and then the boys from 5A battle it out beginning at 8:45. The 2002 GHSA State Basketball Championships, exclusively on the network recognized as the leader in high school sports television, GPTV. You know the old saying, timing is everything. Well, now that the Winter Olympics have been completed in Salt Lake, we just happen to have a story of a young man that is a Junior Olympic hopeful. As our Anthony White explains, this Stockbridge sophomore is focused on one target at a time.
It's not your average sport. There's no thunderous dunks, no spiking of a football after a long touchdown pass, or the roar you hear from a stadium full of screaming fans after a massive home run. But you can't tell Richard Tickle of Stockbridge High School that there's a difference, because the love he has for his sport makes him pretty good.
I knew I was good at shooting, so I started doing it. And last year, I was a freshman. It's my first year at high school, and I started shooting on the rifle team, and I was pretty good at it. And I finally made the varsity team, and my goal was to be the best on the team, and I finally done that, and then be the best in the region.
And to be the best takes long hours and dedication to perfect this sport. Richard embodies all of it.
I come down for practice in the mornings and evenings, and also when I get home, I do physical exercises, push-ups, sit-ups, run sometimes. Because when you run, it gets your heart rate down. You go to calm down, you're in better shape, which allows you to shoot between heartbeats, and that helps out a lot. So not only do I shoot, I also exercise also.
He's very dedicated to his team. I mean, a lot of times he'll help me out when I have problems. I've had freshmen come down and help out with them. And in particular, last week he showed excellent dedication because I dislocated my shoulder in the middle of the match. And if it wasn't for him, we would have lost the match.
Well, Richard hasn't lost many matches over his young career. He stepped into the spotlight as a freshman and hasn't looked over his shoulder since.
Everyone on the team always kind of, I guess they poked fun at me a little bit because I was coming in and started beating them, and I guess they kind of got mad at me. So I was like, what the heck? So I just kept trying, and I wanted to be the best on the team, and I knew I could do it. So that was my goals, and I did.
When he first came in, he was a little outrageous, but we learned to love him. I mean, he's a pretty good guy. If we didn't have him, we'd have lost a lot of matches last year.
Richard is recognized as one of the top shooters in the state, and with his talent, he's heading to Colorado to try out for the Junior Olympic team.
He gets to shoot against other shooters that he will eventually have to outshoot to get there, and he gets to know them.
I'm really excited about going out there. I've never been that far away from home on a match or anything. And I've went to Tennessee, and I've shot in South Georgia, but I'm really excited about going to Colorado, and I'm looking forward to it. My goal is to take first or second so I can be on the national development team, which is where they choose the Olympic shooters from, and that would be a great honor if I could do that.
Rich's first set of targets were pine cones hanging from a tree in his backyard, but now that he's a sophomore here at Stockbridge High School, he's turned out to be a pretty good shot. Who knows, with the 2004 Olympics just 2 years away, maybe his picture might end up on the cover of the newspaper.
I'd love to go in 2004, which is when the next Summer Olympics are, but 2008 is probably when I'll actually get to go, because there's a lot of tough competition. But my goal is just to do my best, keep training hard, and just do what I'm capable of doing.
Well, Richard, you have your eye on the right target, and I'm quite sure you will hit it. From Stockbridge, Anthony White, Prep Sports Plus.
All right, thanks, Anthony. Now, there are other Georgians that will compete in Colorado next month at the Junior Olympic Rifle Championships. Here's the list. Chris Hill of Woodward Academy, Madison County's Aaron Phillips, Will Thomas of Harris County, Roswell's David Landrum. Also from Woodward Academy, Joseph Simino and Jeremy Drennan of Union Grove. As for the women, Charity Kuhn from Harris County, Hardaway's Laura Nickerson, and from Roswell, Karen Landrum and Christy Smith of Madison County. Good luck to all in Colorado. It's Black History Month, and with the high school basketball postseason upon us, what better time to look at an exhibit at the Georgia Sports Hall of Fame that highlights the early accomplishments of African American basketball players. Now, it's the last weekend that you can catch this great exhibit. With more on this story, here's Eric Hunter.
Throughout Black History Month, do yourself a favor. Go into the Georgia Sports Hall of Fame in Macon and enter the Freedom to Play exhibit. There you'll learn about the history of black athletes in the game of basketball. It's on loan from the Naismith Memorial Basketball Hall of Fame in Springfield, Massachusetts. And we're currently the only state in the Southeast scheduled to host Freedom to Play over the next year.
We're real proud to have it, during Black History Month, and proud to be able to tell the story not only nationally, but to be able to weave in the history of Georgia's history into it, the history of the African-American basketball players from Georgia.
Pop Gates is one of the many athletes featured in this Freedom to Play exhibit. He is one of the first great basketball players from the state of Georgia. In fact, he starred at Clark Atlanta University, went on to play for the Buffalo Bisons, who are now our own Atlanta Hawks. Now, this exhibit runs through March 3rd, and they've already had over 1,000 students scheduled to see this exhibit.
It's open to the public 7 days a week. You'll read about life before and after school desegregation. Herb White played his entire career in Georgia, and Stan Lomax coached high school and college hoops in Georgia from 48 to 76. Both witnessed firsthand the inequities between whites and blacks in basketball, the most visible being the surface of the outdoor courts black high school players had to play on.
Primarily, though, it was clay or sand. And in some instances, some enterprising principals might have boarded up their courts so that you could not just come in willy-nilly. You had to pay a price. You had to pay to enter. That was a way of course, keeping the program afloat. But high schools found the necessity to utilize leather balls or rubber balls when playing outside.
I do know there were inequities as far as guys getting scholarships and some of the opportunities that that other guys had. Willie Hawkins, who was one of my childhood heroes, one of the first guys that I remember really taking a hard look at and saying, man, this guy can really play the game different than anybody I've ever seen. I know that when he graduated from high school, I think he had maybe one or two scholarship offers, as opposed to if he'd have been a white player with the same kind of talents that he had, he probably would have had 50 or 60 offers.
So during February, as we learn more about the history of black basketball players in Georgia, and as you high school players take for granted all the modern indoor facilities of today, remember,
hey, we had to do it outdoors in cold weather with no jackets, but we got it done because we love the game.
For Prep Sports Plus, I'm Eric Hunter.
All right, thanks, Eric. Statistics have shown that students that get involved in extracurricular activities tend to do much better in the classroom. Case in point, our Academic Athlete of the Week. Brian Salmon has this story from a town most of you have probably never heard of, Little Wiki.
Some folks say it's better to be lucky than good. Our academic athlete probably wouldn't say that she's the luckiest person in the world, but she doesn't need to be because she's good. This good girl with the credentials to be featured on our big show is Savoyia Barrett, and she's a junior at Long County High School.
She's a good listener. She's not cocky. She will take advice from anybody. So I think she'll do well in Division I or II or even higher because she's just that good.
Savoyia's focus is one of her best attributes. This talent of hers has thrust her to a 3.4 GPA. And on her athletic stages of choice, the softball field and the basketball court, she has excelled with a 396 batting average. And basketball opponents are hammered for an average of 16 points, 5 rebounds, and 4 steals a game. Remember, she's only a junior.
When I'm in the classroom, I'm focused on my studies. When I'm on a basketball court, I'm focused on basketball. And I like to do the best at what I'm doing. If I'm doing it, I'm going to give 110%. Try to give 110% all the time.
I actually go to her softball games and her basketball games. So I'm very involved with her and her extracurricular activities. She's a very hard worker. She's great out on the field and on the court. She's very aggressive, and she's one of the key players, I would say.
Well, this is not all Savoyia's good at. She'd give the King of Pop a run for his money, and she just might show the Harlem Globetrotters a thing or two. But what really impressed me was just how conservative she was when we gave her an Academic Athlete plaque.
Well, congratulations, Savoyia. You're Academic Athlete of the Week. There you go.
This is nice and all, but words just can't express how I feel. How was that?
I think that was great. Congratulations.
Yeah, she's a clown. She's the team clown. You know, our mascot is the Tide, but it should be the clown.
I'm spontaneous, like the backflips after we win games. People didn't know I could do that, and my mom said the other half of the gym dropped their jaws whenever I did it. So I just like doing different stuff to keep people on their toes.
When Savoyia's basketball career is over, she'd like to become a physical therapist, for one. She'd like to remain close to the sport, but also she can relate to those injured. This is why Rebecca Lobo is more than just a WNBA star to her.
She tore ACL like I did, same leg, and almost the same way. I tore my ACL in eighth grade, the first minute of the first game of the season, as did she.
Well, we're glad you recovered, and look at you now. You're an Academic Athlete of the Week. Reporting for Prep Sports Plus, I'm Brian Salmon.
All right, good story. Thanks, Brian. By the way, for you folks who like to keep up with the areas we cover geographically, the town of Little Wiki is located southwest of Savannah near Fort Stewart. Just thought you might be interested. Around the state of Georgia, we all know the key to the Braves' success over the years has been their pitching staff. As our Justin Wallace explains, there is one high school team down in South Georgia with a similar situation in 2002.
Who Framed Roger Rabbit and Rain Man were tops at the box office. Cheers and The Cosby Show were television staples. Dirty Dancing, the album, was cleaning up at record stores, and the first George Bush was busy campaigning for president. The year 1988, a time Wilcox County High School baseball coach Tim Harris will not soon forget. See, it was that year his Patriot baseball team came up just short of winning a state championship, finishing with the runner-up trophy. Well, 14 years later, his current team, most in diapers back then, believes it's got what it takes to get him back in the championship game.
We did well last year. I mean, we made the Elite Eight, but I just hope that, you know, we make it a lot farther and maybe have a shot at a state championship.
Most of the players return from last year's squad that won the Region 4A title and made the state quarterfinals. Now, despite the fact that the entire infield returns intact, an infield that averaged nearly three double plays a game last season, you ask any of them what the team's biggest strength is, and they'll tell you.
Pitching. Had to be pitching.
Well, we didn't lose any pitching, and in baseball, that's an important thing is pitching.
Wilcox County has a rotation of three top-flight pitchers. Junior Rusty Harris, 8-4 last season with a 1.12 ERA. Junior R.D. Reinhardt, 7-2 last year with a 1.78 earned run average. And senior Matt Fagan, himself a four-game winner. These guys will admit they will not overpower you. Instead, they'll come at you in Greg Maddux fashion.
Less pitches and quick outs and easy innings to get in and score some runs.
A lot of ground balls, get a lot of two outs instead of one, it always helps out.
While the team will go on and on about pitching, watching them in the batter's box would lead the casual observer to believe this team beat you with offense. And, well, yeah, they do that too. Matt Fagan led the team in batting last season with a .380 batting average, and you realize watching him hit that he's not a ground ball kind of guy. All in all, six guys hit over .300, and they're all back.
They've been playing together a long time. They all know each other. They can all poke fun at each other, make jokes about each other and each other's girlfriends even, and still, you know, pull together and play hard.
Junior Rusty Harris has the most pressure put on his shoulders. Not only does he have to be a starting pitcher and a starting shortstop, but he has to eat dinner with coach every night. Of course, at home, Rusty can drop the coach stuff and just call him dad.
He's tough, you know, tough at home, tough on the field. He pushes me a lot more.
We come from a baseball family. Everybody's into baseball, and it's just our way of life during the spring.
In his 17 years coaching at Wilcox County, believe it or not, Coach Tim Harris never had lights to work with until now. As you can see, these light poles have been installed behind me at a cost of about $75,000. Now, when the Cubs put lights at Wrigley Field, there was a lot of uproar and commotion. It was very controversial. But this is one break in tradition that Coach Harris does not seem to mind.
A small county with 7,000 people, and as bright as these lights are going to be, it's going to draw a lot of people just because of curiosity. When they get here and find out it's just a baseball game, a bunch of them might just turn around and leave.
Wow. It's never been here before, but I'm going to enjoy them, and I'm sure the team's going to enjoy them.
With the talent on this year's squad, Wilcox County residents might just want to stick around. This show is just getting started. For Prep Sports Plus, I'm Justin Wallace.
The only park for miles with lights reminds me of that great baseball movie, Field of Dreams. All right, thanks, Justin. There's a big golf tournament coming up. It's a girls' golf tournament in about 3 weeks, the 8th annual GACA Georgia Peach, which will take place on Saturday, March 23rd at the Hard Labor Creek State Park in Rutledge. The Georgia Peach is open to all skill levels. You can even be a beginner and still play in this event. I wish I could. Coaches, if you have any students that are interested in playing in the Georgia Peach, you can get more information on this tourney by calling Coach Russ Rainey at Marietta High. The number, 770-428-2631, extension 3152. That's 770-428-2631, then dial extension 3152. Well, that does it for this edition of Prep Sports Plus. Thanks for watching, everybody. Quick reminder, don't forget, we'll be with you next Friday live from Macon. It all begins at 12 noon Eastern time. The basketball championships right here on GPTV. On behalf of the entire Prep Sports Plus team, I'm Jim Giannacchio. Have a great weekend. And remember, if you have some extra time, catch a high school sport. So long, everybody.
Thanks for watching Prep Sports Plus.